Hello, welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to take a tour of Mother Shipton's cave. Now, Mother Shipton's cave is in Knaresborough, which is near York in Northern England. And it's England's oldest visitor attraction, and it's been open since 1630. You can drive in. There is a car park. There's a fee. They usually charge per car of people. It's such a beautiful walk to the Mother Shipton's cave. It doesn't take that long. It only takes about 15 minutes, I would say. The route is very beautiful. You've got these beautiful running water and falls. You've got the birds singing in the trees. And such a beautiful day when I was there in April. And it felt like a summer's day. And you can see it's beautiful scenery. You've got picnic areas. And there's the castle on the hill. You will also see signs to give you directions, so you can go to the Mother Shipton's cave, the petrifying well, the wishing well. There's also the gift shop and museum to see. But there's also today, when I was there, which was after Easter, there's also some lovely, well put together Easter displays, which we'll see in a short while. So you can see how beautiful this is. This is the River Nid. And it's just so peaceful and tranquil. There's not many visitors here today. It's a school day, so it's not a weekend. So it's showing you here the old mill you can see in the background there. It used to be the old mill. So here are the Easter displays, which, you know, you can see it's been well designed. They've made these huts and they've got these characters inside, and I think it would be a joy for children to explore them. I don't know what replaces them when the summer months come, but this is what it's like today. You can see it's so beautiful. It's like a mini Easter village. So we'll go and have a look at some of these huts. So you've got wooden mushrooms or wooden toadstools, you've got a little wooden seat and little bird box. It's just so beautiful. So these are like makeshift barns. You can see it just looks like an olden day barn with the little hens and chickens and ducks. So cute. Then you've got Humpty Dumpty. And this is the bunny post office. Post a letter to the Easter Bunny. And you can see there's a post box. And it's really beautiful the way they put all the flowers around the entrance and everything. It just makes it look so pretty. And with these Easter wreaths, which are now becoming very popular. and a little pigsty. Isn't that sweet? With a little peacock there in the background. And here's like a picnic area with the Easter Bunny Tippy Town, it's called, where you can sit and eat. And Humpty Dumpty. I think it's really quite creative and imaginative, and I just think it's so beautiful walking around this place, even though I'm an adult. I just think it'd be great for kids. There's Pinocchio sat on that carved log. I think in the summer months it'll be very busy, so this is why they have the one-way system. So we're just about near now, we're so near now to the Petrifying Well and to the Mother Shipton's cave. So this explains about the Petrifying Well, and that it's the oldest England's oldest attraction. And behind the Petrifying Well is a wishing well. So you can see the water there. That's the water from the Petrifying Well. So the Petrifying Well actually turns things into stone if it's left long enough under the dripping water. And you can see the cave here, the Petrifying Well, I should say. And And you can see all those objects hanging down, and they're all getting turned into stone from the minerals in the water. There is audio you can listen to. I'll just put it on.
Do you think the well looks more like a waterfall? Well, long ago, before people had taps in their homes, any place where you could get drinking water from was known as a well. Do you know what petrify means? It means to turn solid or stiff. The word is used a lot to describe how frightened someone is. Hundreds of years ago, poorly people used to come from a long way away to take a shower under the falling waters because they believed the waters were magic and would make them better. The water comes from a long way underground, almost a mile. The water has a lot of minerals in it, but it's not like the mineral water you buy in bottles to drink. This water has many more minerals in it, so don't drink it. Can you see all the different items and teddy bears hanging under the waters and turning to stone? The waters fall onto them and leave all the minerals behind. They build up and turn the teddy solid. And it only takes 3 minutes. I'm afraid because we get so many requests, we cannot petrify visitors' items. Can you spot the 2 oldest items up there petrifying? Yes, you can't. Do you see the 2 lumps sticking out halfway up the rock face? They're hats, left 150 years ago by a young couple. I don't think they'll be coming back to pick them up now, do you? Hundreds of years ago, the people that lived in Maresborough thought the well was magic. They were scared to come down here. They thought the well would turn them into stone. Old Mother Shipton was born in the cave just over there. She thinks her mum must have been very brave to have a baby in the cave and to come down here tonight in a funny place. Thank you.
Jonathan Ross came to Mother Shipton's cave when he was filming the Jonathan Ross's Myths and Legends, and he donated his boxer shorts to be turned into stone. I believe these are the orange boxer shorts he donated. So you can watch his boxer shorts getting turned into stone. Please see the link below for that show. When you get to the end of the park, you'll find a gift shop and a museum, and in there you can see other objects that have been petrified, objects belonging to other celebrities. Just around the corner, there's the wishing well. Now, walking into the wishing well, I don't know if they normally have lights in there, but it was very, very dark. I couldn't see anything. It's best if you take a torch in there with you. You're supposed to be able to make a wish if you put your hand in the water and then let the water dry on your hand. But you're not supposed to ask for money, or you're not supposed to ask for harm to anyone else. And apparently people keep coming back because their wishes come true. Mother Shipton was born in this cave here, so we're just going to head in this cave now, and they have audio as well, so I'm going to play the audio for you.
a baby was born during a thunderstorm. The baby was named Ursula and was reputedly born disfigured and twisted. Townsfolk heard about the birth and said a witch had been born in the cave next to the magic well. Mother and daughter lived in this cave for 2 years until eventually the Abbot of Beverley intervened. The mother, Agatha, still would not reveal the father's identity and volunteered to spend the rest of her days in a convent in Nottinghamshire. The father was never traced. The Abbot found a local family to provide a home for. As she grew into a young woman, it was clear she was very different. Her spine was twisted, her shoulders haunched, and she was unable to walk without the aid of a stick. She was constantly taunted. For peace and quiet, she would walk in the forest surrounding her birthplace, picking wild herbs and flowers. But Ursula had a gift. She could predict the future. She predicted small local events at first, but she developed her powers almost as quickly as her reputation spread. People travelled miles to visit her, here in this cave, and ask what the future held for them. The famous historian Samuel Pepys grimly recorded in his equally famous diaries during the Fire of London that Mother Shipton's prophecy had come true. At the age of 24, she married a local carpenter, Tobias Shipton, and people said that he must have been under the influence of one of her love potions or spells. When he died 2 years later, again, local people blamed Ursula. Even though she never had children, she became known as Mother, and later Old Mother Shipton. This was a commonly used mark of respect for an old woman in those days. She died aged 73 in 1561. She, of course, predicted her own death to the day. No one knows where she is buried. All that is known is that she was denied a church burial. The most popular theory is that she was buried by friends in a secret ceremony in an unmarked grave, somewhere in the forest that she loved and spent so much time in. In the 1600s, Mother Shipton became a household name, with many pubs named after her, puppet shows and fortune tellers using her name and image, even her own brand of soap. Before you leave, be sure to make a wish in the wishing well.
Can you see that eye behind Mother Shipton in the rock? It's very spooky. I can't help but wonder what else has been petrified in this cave. So we're now going to head to the little gift shop and museum at the end of this path. This path is called Beech Avenue and is listed as a grade 2 walk due to having the very old and tallest beech trees in the country. Let us have a browse in the little gift shop and museum.
Thank you.
On the way out, you'll pass these coin trees. So take a coin with you to hammer in the log and then make a wish. So I've hammered my 20 pence piece in there. The next time I come back, I'll be looking for that. I've enjoyed my time here at Mother Shipton's cave. Thank you for watching. My next video will be about Knaresborough. So, bye for now.